Namaskar. Today we will discuss about granulite facies. We have already discussed about intermediate pressure temperature facies, right from geolite facies, green schist facies, amphibolite facies, and the granulite facies is a part of intermediate facies where pressure and temperature increase. Granulite facies, the important contents, introduction, characteristics, minerals, metamorphic reactions, subfaces, pyroxene granulite subfaces, Dewart classification for granulite facies, physical condition of metamorphism, conclusion. On the basis of pressure and temperature, we can divide the metamorphic facies into three types, mainly facies of low pressure, second facies of intermediate pressure, and third facies of higher pressure. Miyashiro originally recognized three different facies series, a geolite, prehanite, pumpelite, blue schist, eclogite type, second a typical Barrowian type characterized by green schist, epidote amphibolite, amphibolite, granulite type characterized by paragenesis of kyanite sillimanite type, and third an Abukama type of green schist, amphibolite, granulite characterized by the paragenesis of andalusite sillimanite type. The faces of intermediate pressure or Barrowian type are listed below in order of increasing temperature and pressure of metamorphism. Geolite faces, green schist faces, amphibolite faces, and lastly granulite faces. The rock of this faces series belong to the very high rank of metamorphites, in which muscovite is no longer stable, and consequently potass feldspar coexist with aluminosilicates, polymorphs, that is sillimanite. Moreover, in rocks of suitable bulk composition, orthorhombic pyroxene characteristically appears in place of anthophyllite, gadarite, or cummingtonite. The paragenesis of impure calcareous rocks is similar to the amphibolite facies. The individual minerals in rocks of the granulite facies display a number of distinctive and persistent properties, like hyperstene is a strongly pleochroic from green to deep pink to yellow, and typically so a rather high Al2O3 content of 6 to 9 weight percent. Garnets are rich in pyrope, almandine, and sometimes contain as much as 55% pyrope and up to 20% grasolarite. Micropyrite structure is characteristic of alkali feldspar, and the plesioclase similarly tends to the antipyrrhotic, is already consumed, that is muscovite plus minus quartz is absent. All the amphiboles are absent, that is anthophyllite, cummingtonite, hornblende, gadarite, tremolite, and actinolite. A number of metamorphic reactions have been suggested to account for the diagonistic appearance of orthopyroxene. Reaction 1, change of anthophyllite to hyperstene. Reaction, anthophyllite give rise to orthopyroxene plus quartz plus vapor. Second reaction, disappearance of hornblende. Hornblende plus quartz give rise to orthopyroxene plus clinopyroxene plus minus plesioclase plus vapor, marks the beginning of granulite facies. Now third reaction, hornblende plus biotite plus quartz give rise to orthopyroxene plus potass feldspar plus plesioclase plus water. Fourth reaction, hornblende plus almandine garnet plus quartz gave rise to orthopyroxene plus plagioclase plus vapor. Fifth reaction, biotite plus quartz gave rise to orthopyroxene plus almandine plus potassium feldspar plus water. Reaction sixth, biotite plus selenite plus quartz gave rise to almandine plus potassium feldspar plus water. All the reaction involving hornblende, biotite, anthophyllite are divariant on account of varying Fe and Mg ratio and also condition of P water less than P total as discussed later. That is, the reaction start at certain temperatures, but all equilibrium phases will be present over a temperature range until with rising grade, all hornblende, biotite, anthophyllite disappears. Thus, two subfaces, hornblende granulites and pyroxene granulites, are recognized. On the basis of divariant reactions, divariant reaction because they are occur over a wide range of pressure and temperature condition. Granulite faces divided into two subfaces. First subfaces is hornblende granulite subfaces in which hornblende and biotite are present in the garnetiferous and pyroxene bearing assemblages of more water. Second, the pyroxene granulite subfaces taking hornblende and biotite with less water or absent. The first assemblages, that is your hornblende granulite faces, and second is your pyroxene granulite subfaces. Let us see the ACF, AKF, AFM diagram on the screen, and we can predict the different assemblages like peldic, quartzofeldspathic, basic, calcareous, etc. Now take up the peltic and quartzofeldspathic assemblages. The first assemblage is your selenite, perthite, quartz, plagioclase, graphite. Second is a quartz, perthite, hyperstene, plagioclase, garnet. Third important assemblage is quartz, perthite, hyperstene, plagioclase, that is also known as acid charnokite. If plagioclase is more than potass feldspar, then rock is called enderbite. So that is very common on the basis of presence of potass feldspar and plagioclase. If potass feldspar more than plagioclase with presence of hyperstene plus quartz, the rock will be your charnokite. Vice versa, if potass feldspar less than plagioclase, then it will be enderbite, that is also known as basic charnokite. Now the important basic and mafic assemblages, that is plagioclase, hyperstene, diapsite, quartz plus minus perthite, that is also known as basic charnokite. The next important assemblage is your calcareous assemblage. Number 5, diapsite, plagioclase, gracilorite, quartz. Number 6, gracilorite, diapsite, calcite, plus minus quartz. In hornblende granulite faces, all assemblages are same except minor amount of hornblende and biotite present in basic and peltic assemblages. Dewart classification for granulite faces. In 1965, Dewart, he proposed some new subfaces. They continued typical assemblages of clinopyroxene and biotite, that is based on the activity of water. We will see on the screen the sketch where we can observe how the load pressure increase and faces change with activity of water. The first faces is your hornblende, clinopyroxene, almandine subfaces. Second is your clinopyroxene almandine subfaces with clinopyroxene plus garnet plus quartz. The reaction means reaction is your orthopyroxene plus plagioclase give rise to clinopyroxene plus quartz plus water. The clinopyroxene and garnet product indicate the increase of pressure and temperature. The third important assemblage is your hornblende orthopyroxene plagioclase subfaces. Fourth is your orthopyroxene plagioclase surfaces. The important reaction is your number fifth is your cordite almandine biotite surfaces. Number six is your cordite almandine surfaces. That is the product of your high activity of water, or better we can say, if your biotite is present, then activity of water is more, and biotite or hornblende is absent, then that so anhydrous type or activity of water is less. The temperature site is normally increased where the activity of water is low. This is based on the different type of load pressure and temperature and activity of waters. Dewars in 1965 has proposed a six-fold classification of granulite facies. The two subfaces of relatively high load pressure are characterized by clinopyroxene almandine and two intermediate subfaces by orthopyroxene plagioclase and two subfaces of relatively low load pressure by cordite almandine assemblies. Of these six subfaces, the three with relatively high water vapor pressure contain hornblende and biotite in addition to characteristic anhydrous assemblies of the three subfaces of relatively low water vapor pressure. Hornblende orthopyroxene plagioclase granulite surfaces are plagioclase granulite surfaces of Dewars correspond an orthopyroxene hornblende granulites and pyroxene surfaces mentioned above. The assemblies orthopyroxene plus plagioclase characteristic of the above surfaces become unstable if the pressure exceed a particular value at constant temperature. The two minerals react each others to form clinopyroxene almandine pyroxene granulites by the following reaction. Orthopyroxene plus plagioclase give rise to clinopyroxene plus garnet plus quartz. This reaction has been investigated by Ring and Greenwood in 1967, who obtained equilibrium condition of the reaction at about 700 degree centigrade between 8 to 10 kilobar. Though this reaction, therefore, the pair orthopyroxene plagioclase is replaced by the pair clinopyroxene plus garnet, and thus plagioclase now coexist with clinopyroxene and garnet. This is the characterized of clinopyroxene almandine granulite surfaces. This is the entirely devoid of hornblende and biotite. The corresponding surfaces at higher P water is hornblende clinopyroxene almandine granulite surfaces. The peltic calcareous assemblages is similar as hornblende orthopyroxene plagioclase and orthopyroxene plagioclase granulite surfaces. The cordite almandine surfaces occupy relatively low load pressure region of the granulite facies environment. This facies is thus transitioned between orthopyroxene plagioclase surfaces and pyroxene Hornfels facies at higher and lower pressure respectively. The corresponding surfaces at relatively higher P water, cordite almandine biotite surfaces formed. The typical peltic assemblages are cordite almandine surfaces. Important assemblages: first, the cordite garnet hyperstene potass feldspar quartz plagioclase. Second, cordite garnet selenite cordierite almandine biotite subfaces. Third, cordierite garnet hyperthin biotite plagioclase. Fourth is your cordierite almandine selenite biotite plagioclase. The basic and calcareous assemblages are similar to the orthopyroxene plagioclase and hornblende plagioclase subfaces. There are several reactions proposed for the appearance of cordierite in these surfaces. The first important reaction is your almandine plus biotite give rise to cordierite plus hyperthin plus potassium feldspar plus water. Second reaction is your biotite plus selenite plus quartz give rise to cordierite plus minus almandine plus potassium feldspar plus water. Third reaction is your biotite plus quartz give rise to cordierite plus almandine plus orthopyroxene plus potassium feldspar plus water. Next important phase is the hornblende orthopyroxene plagioclase surfaces. On the basis of ACF, AKF and AFM diagram, the following assemblages are observed. Here every assemblage is same except a small amount of hornblende and biotite present. If suppose we compare the two faces, that is your pyroxene Hornfels faces as well as hornblende Hornfels faces, the basic difference is the activity of water. If activity of water increase, the hydrous face, that is biotite and hornblende, appear, and the faces, that is hornblende pyroxene, appear. Important reaction within these surfaces and hornblende orthopyroxene plagioclase surfaces change into orthopyroxene plagioclase surfaces, that is the hornblende plus quartz give rise to orthopyroxene plus plagioclase plus vapor. Next reaction is your hornblende plus almandine plus quartz give rise to orthopyroxene plus plagioclase plus vapor. Next reaction is your anthophyllite give rise to orthopyroxene plus quartz plus vapor. Second important surfaces, that is your orthopyroxene plagioclase surfaces. Chanokite assemblies, that is typical chanokite without garnet and chanokite with garnet, that is the OPX orthopyroxene potassium feldspar. If garnet present, then with quartz, that is known as chanokite with garnet. If garnet is absent, that is your chanokite acid in nature, or we can say the chanokite without garnet. The assemblage is your hyperthin potassium feldspar quartz. Now basic rocks, plagioclase plus diapsite plus minus orthopyroxene plus potassium feldspar plus quartz. Calcareous assemblies, plagioclase, diapsite, grassulite, potassium feldspar plus minus quartz. Number 6, calcite, diapsite, grassulite, potassium feldspar plus minus quartz. Now the next important assemblages, that is your ultra basic assemblies, diapsite, orthopyroxene, potassium feldspar plus minus quartz. The reaction taken place at the junction of these two surfaces, that is biotite plus quartz give rise to orthopyroxene plus garnet plus potassium feldspar plus vapor. Another important reaction is your biotite plus selenite plus quartz give rise to almandine plus potassium feldspar plus vapor. So the higher pressure side. Reaction 3, that is hornblende plus clinopyroxene plus almandine surfaces. One can see the assemblies with the help of ACF, AKF and AFM diagrams. Reactions, orthopyroxene plus plagioclase give rise to garnet plus clinopyroxene plus quartz. Four faces, that is your clinopyroxene garnet surfaces. If we will see the ACF, AKF and AFM diagram, we can observe that peltic, calcareous and ultramafic mineral assemblages are same, only change in basic assemblies. The basic assemblies is clinopyroxene, garnet, plagioclase, quartz. Number fifth is your corderite almandine biotite surfaces. Here, one new minerals appear first time, that is corderite, with the help of ACF, AKF and A-F-M- diagram, we can observe different assemblages. Important reaction in these surfaces occur and corderite almandine biotite surfaces change into corderite almandine surfaces. The secondary biotite plus sillimanite plus quartz give rise to the corderite plus garnet plus potass feldspar plus wepper. Another reaction is your biotite plus sillimanite plus quartz give rise to corderite plus potass feldspar plus wepper. Six surfaces is your corderite almandine surfaces. On the basis of ACF, AKF and A-F-M- diagram, we can observe different assemblages. The basic calcareous ultramafic assemblages are same as in orthopyroxene plagioclase and orthopyroxene plagioclase hornblende surfaces. The only difference is in peltic assemblages. The peltic assemblies, assemblies 1, garnet plus corderite plus sillimanite plus potass feldspar plus quartz. Assemblies 2, orthopyroxene plus garnet plus corderite plus potass feldspar plus quartz. While anhydrous in nature, no biotite is present in peltic rocks. If biotite present, then corderite almandine biotite surfaces. All assemblages are same. When Fe rich portion, then biotite plus quartz give rise to garnet plus corderite plus orthopyroxene plus potass feldspar plus wepper. When FeMg biotite, Mg biotite plus quartz give rise to orthopyroxene plus corderite plus potass feldspar plus wepper. Next reaction is your biotite plus garnet plus quartz give rise to corderite plus orthopyroxene plus potass feldspar plus wepper. Granulite surfaces, CO2 present in corderite, no water in a structure formula, half CO2 and half H2O. Physical condition of metamorphism. In some region, successive zone characterized respectively by amphibolite faces, the hornblende granulite surfaces, hornblende orthopyroxene plagioclase surfaces, and pyroxene granulite surfaces, orthopyroxene plagioclase surfaces, constitute a progressive sequence of advancing metamorphic grade. Elsewhere, again, there is a textural evidence in form of coronas and other replacement structures that pyroxene granulite assemblies are in process of retrogressive metamorphism to hornblende granulites or amphibolite faces. Assemblages, these field and textural relationship are constant with widely preventing view that the granulite faces represent high temperature of metamorphism. The temperature is of the order of 700 to 800 degrees centigrade as shown by the following reaction. Mg enthophyllite give rise to orthopyroxene plus quartz plus water. The reaction carried out by Greenwood in 1963 at 745 degrees centigrade 1 kilobar. Second reaction is muscovite plus quartz give rise to potass feldspar plus sillimanite plus water, which occur at 662 degrees centigrade 3 kilobar by day 1973. The reaction biotite plus sillimanite plus quartz give rise to corderite plus minus garnet plus potass feldspar plus wepper has been studied experimentally by Holdway and Lee 1977, and the equilibrium condition of reactions are 700 to 750 degrees centigrade between 4 to 8 kilobar. The reaction is already completed in the upper part of the amphibolite faces. Mg enthophyllite give rise to orthopyroxene plus quartz plus water. The XMG equal to 0.6. The obtained temperature is 775 degree centigrade 6 kilobar and 680 degree centigrade 5 kilobar. When XMG equal to 0.8, the temperature is 775 degree centigrade 6 kilobar and 720 degree centigrade 5 kilobar. The above two reactions, MgFe enthophyllite, investigated by Tever and Henrichsen in 1975. They also studied the above reaction in the natural enthophyllite and synthetic one and found the breakdown temperature as 835 degree centigrade 6 kilobar and 750 degree centigrade 5 kilobar. MgFe gadarite plus quartz give rise to cordierite plus hyperstein plus water. The reaction occur at 755 degree centigrade 2 kilobar, 705 degree centigrade 1 kilobar by Winkler 1966. Partial melting of amphibolite through the reaction hornblende plus quartz give rise to orthopyroxene plus clinopyroxene plus plagioclase. The reaction occur between 700 to 750 at 4 to 10 kilobar. It seems likely that granulite facies pass a considerable range of pressure temperature of kyanite almandine rich composition of hyperstein, and the pyroxene rich garnet are believed to reflect high pressure condition of their formation. The association of clinopyroxene plus garnet plus plagioclase also indicate a pressure of 8 to 10 kilobar at about 700 degree centigrade. As already mentioned above, on the other hand, pressure of sillimanite plus cordierite in some granulite suggest that these are formed at relatively low pressure, maybe as low as 7 kilobar. Furthermore, the pyroxene granulite facies rocks are essentially dry or anhydrous, suggesting very effect on reaction, including the transformation of hydroxyl bearing minerals into anhydrous ones. For example, Henrichsen in 1975 have shown experimentally that the breakdown reaction of hornblende, one natural and two synthetic, occur in temperature range from 850 degree centigrade to 1020 degree centigrade at 1 kilobar. Water pressure where PS2 equal to P total, these temperature are not reached in regional metamorphism. On the other hand, lowering PS2 relative to P total, that is P water less than P total, decrease the reaction temperature at constant P total can be realized only in deeper part of the crust, where very little water had occurred in igneous rocks and to metamorphosed sedimentary, which had lost most of their water either during long period of regional metamorphism or during previous period of high grade metamorphism. In many areas, granulite facies of rocks are polymetamorphic, and these facies of rocks are restricted to precambrian terrain. The coarse content on the metamorphic intermediate pressure facies being with the introduction followed by the description of characteristic minerals, metamorphic reactions, surfaces, pyroxene granulite surfaces with the help of ACF, AKF, A-dash, F-dash, M-dash diagrams and the important assemblages like peltic, basic, ultra-basic and calcareous, Dewart classification of granulites and finally, the physical condition of metamorphism during granulite facies. Thus, on the basis of the detailed study of different subfaces and also with the support of experimental data, we can conclude that during granulite facies, the temperature varies between 700 to 750 to 850 degrees centigrade and the pressure in the range of 6 to 10 kilobar.